Folks, welcome to your fourth Elasticsearch Kibana and Logstash tutorial for the beginners. This is Atik Ahmed. In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about what is get, post, put and delete method in Elasticsearch, and also we'll be going to perform all the methods from the Node.js, which is a server-side application, and we'll basically see the result. So let's go and do some hands-on coding. Already created a project. So this is the index.js and this is the entry point of the application. So let me show you first readme.txt. So we have to create an npm init for creating a package.json, and we need to install a few package, which is config, Elasticsearch and chalk, course, express and body parser. And what I'm doing here, I'm basically doing the database connection, which has been defined the db.js, and I'm defining into the Elasticsearch. So you can see the db.js here itself. And this is coming from config. So config.elasticsearch.url and config.elasticsearch.port, which is coming from the config folder and default.json. So you can see that this is all the configuration related stuff. This is nothing but the my Elasticsearch indices. So currently the indices I am following here, students, if you are having the few n number of indices, so you can basically change here the name as well. So if you are having the company, so you can say here company, and also you can mention here itself like that way. So currently I'm using only for only the students, right? So after that I'm using the course policy and body parser. All the routes I have been defined the folder of inside routes. Then I'm saying that server.listen.port. So my port is nothing but my application.server port, which I have been mentioned 3500, right? So in the part of routes, here you can see that I have a few API, so I'm going to discuss one by one. So I have a get API, post API, delete API, put API and all those things. And inside the controller, I have a few file, which is for the delete API. I'm using the delete file, get API. I'm using the get file, registration API. I'm using the registration, user details update. I'm using the user details, and this is nothing but a X factor search. So I'll explain each and everything one by one. The first thing is that what I'm going to do now, I'm basically start my Elasticsearch. So let me start the Elasticsearch first. All right, so I have started my Elasticsearch. So looks like my Elasticsearch is already running. So let me open the browser. So I have installed the Elasticsearch extension head. So yeah, so my Elasticsearch is already running and it is basically listening the port number of 9200, right? And currently I have only two indices, which is student and company, and my company is holding the record of 10,000 and my student is only having 35 record, right? So let me go and run the application first. So my entry point of the application is index.js, which I have told you. So this is the entry point of the application and it's listening the port number of 3500. So I'll go and run the application first. So I'm going to execute this API first to check the things whether my application is properly working or not. So what I'll do now, I'll do localhost 3500, then I'm trying to click on send. Yes, my API is working and I'm getting the status code of 200. All right. So in the next part, say for example, I have the indices of company and the students. I want to get the record of either students or company. So for that reason, I have written a pieces of code and my code has been present in get indices data, which has been coming from controller get indices data. So inside the controller I have a file called get indices data.js. All right. So from here itself, I'm calling this function, which is get each indices data. So I'm going to copy it. So if I search it, and this is the file I'm calling here itself. All right. So I'm going to run, I'm going to hit this API from the postman. So let's see what result I'll get. So search all data students. So this students is nothing but my Elasticsearch indices name. All right. So what I'm doing here, I'm telling to this particular API, so go to that function and get the result of 0 to 1000 and match all. I want to get all the records. If I'm getting the response, so give me the response hits dot hits, because Elasticsearch, while they are storing the file like data, they will be storing under hits dot hits, and give me the status of 200 and give me the response of the API. So I click on send. So you can see that. So the method is basically get, and I'm passing the method of get. So you can see that I'm getting the result of student indices. All right. So let me show you one more thing. You can see that index type and ID. So this data, if you go to the structure query, if you go to browser, you can see that the structure of the data is almost same what we are getting from the postman itself, right? Index, which is nothing but a student, type is nothing but a cap student, ID score, and this is my data. All right. So in the next API, so if I want to get the single data from the particular indices, so I need to execute this URL. Okay, and again the same way, it's coming from the same file, get indices data, and I'll copy the function name, and I'm passing the function name here itself. And what I'm telling here, give me the particular student ID match. If the student ID is getting matched, then give me the response, right? And again, I'm basically following the index name and index type. You can see that, and index name is coming from student.index and student.type. So it is nothing but student.index and student.type. All right. So what I'll do now, I'll copy this URL and I'm pasting here itself. So since my method is a post, and in my body I have to pass, so my header is application JSON. Let me close it. So it is application JSON. And here I have to pass content type. In my body I have to pass student ID. Say for example I want to get the student ID of 5. So this student ID is, I have been defined in this function here itself, request.body.studentID, and this student ID has to be present here itself. Okay, so let me hit the API here. So you can see that I'm getting the result of student ID 5. So I'm telling to this API, like, give me the result where student ID of 5, right? So based on the ID, I'm getting all the result like age, department, skills, and leaves, right? In the next API, which is a search, which is a pretty interesting thing as well. So say for example I have an indices and I want to get the repeated record from the particular field. So say for example I'm having a department and I have a huge number of data and I want to filter it out like how many department has been repeated how many times, right? So for that reason, I have to create a JSON file. So I'll explain that way, that as well. So you can see that get repeated field of indices data, the function is coming from again the get indices data, and here I have a X factor search dot repeated item search. Again, the X factor search is coming from my X search, which is this file, and repeated item search, which is again this file, and it extend the X factor search. So I have a few lines of code which basically used to filter all those things. Then what I am doing here, indices of student, which is nothing but the student JSON file. So this is the most important thing. So let me open the student of JSON file here as well. So here you can see that I have a student indices. I am telling give me all the records of department. It has to be matched with the department dot keyword, and the order has to be a ascending order. So this is the example of aggregation actually, right? So I am doing the aggregation, and I am also telling give me the count of department dot keyword. The size has to be max 100 and the order has to be ascending order, right? So once I got that, so I think yeah, this is the once I got that, I am sending the filtering and I am getting the result here itself. So what I'll do now, I'll basically run the particular API from the postman. So my index is basically which is students, and what is htype here? So htype is nothing but if you go to here itself, I'm saying if the htype I'm taking here, if the search type is filter, so I'll take the filter here. So let me hit the API. So I think it's not a post, it's a get request, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, it's a get request. So let me hit the postman. Yeah, so you can see that I'm getting the result. So for the better view, what I'll do now, I'll basically copy the URL and I open my browser, and from here I'm hitting this API, and just let me close it quick. So here in the aggregation part, you can see that I have a arts department 10, commerce department in 16, and science department is 9, right? So you can see that here itself I am getting the things, and inside hits and hits I am getting all the records as well, right? So this is all about this API. In the next API we will be going to discuss about how to insert a single record into your Elasticsearch. So for inserting the data, we need to pass the method of post, so which is insert single data. This is the URL, and we'll be calling the insert API. So insert API again, it's a file under the registration, under the controller, I'm sorry. So if I open the registration file, let me close this. So here you can see that insert single data I am calling here itself, and here I am taking student ID, age, department, skills and leaves. Okay, so what I will do now, I will first copy this URL, insert single data. We are going to insert our data, single data, into the Elasticsearch. So of course the method is obviously post, and the records we have to pass: student ID, age, department, skill and leaves. So I guess I already have a student ID, so I'll make it as a 51, and we don't need student ID. We need age, department, skill and leaves. So in the age will be our student is 18, department is department is IT. Skill will be an array which is Node.js. I must say Elasticsearch, and again I must say HTML5 CSS, and the libs will be, it's an object, will be CL will be 5, PL will be 4, which is a paid leaf, casual leaf, and SL will be 3. Let me check the format of these things. I think so we need to make it as a comma here. Alright, so looks good. So let me open the code itself. So we are going to execute these lines of code. We are going to send the student ID, age, department, skill and leaves. Yes, we are sending. So let me go and hit the API. So you can see that one record has been created, right, which is student ID is 51. So if I want to get the record, I think we already have the record here itself. So which is search of single data, search single data, we have to pass the student ID only. So this is the insert single data, search single data, which is the method of get, I think, sorry, the method of post. Yes, you can see that this is the field we have inserted, correct? Alright, so we have seen how to insert a single record into Elasticsearch. Okay, so for the next we are going to discuss about the update API. So for the update we are using that method of put. What happening here, so update API, again it's coming from the file of user details update, which is has been located inside the folder of controller, and so this is the file user details update. So here what I am doing, I am basically sending the ID and student ID, ID of the particular documents, and the student ID, age, department, skills and leave, right? So let me grab the URL first, so which is update user data. So I think I have already update user data, and this is the things we have to pass. So I have to update the student ID, which is 51. So 51, you can see that so currently record I am having, which is department is IT, and I have only 4 skills, and casual leave, paid leave and sick leave will be 5, 4, 3. So I'll make it as a 4, and I have added one more skills which is called AWS, and I have added IT and department, so which is IT initially it was there, and I need to pass this ID, right? So I click on send. So once I send, you can see that one result has been updated. So initially I am getting only 4 skill and 5, 4, 3. So if I hit it once again, I am getting 5, 4, 4 and 5 skills. Okay. So what happened if I change the student ID 51 to 53? So if I click on hit, so it will be again updated the 53. Right. So this is all about the update API, and in the next part we'll be going to discuss about the delete user. So say for example I want to delete the one record from the particular indices. So what I'm going to do now, so this is again the delete API, and delete API I'm calling from here itself. Again it's a file inside the controller which is delete user details. So let me grab that file. So here itself I am calling again student ID, I'm saying if the student ID is getting matched, please make it delete the particular record from the indices. All right. So here itself, I have to pass delete user data and click on new tab. I'm saying localhost, which is delete user data, and the body I have to pass raw JSON, and the method will be app.delete, right? So I have to pass the delete method. So in the delete method, initially, say for example, I have a record of student ID of 5. Yes, I have a record. So I have to delete the particular student ID record, right? So what I'll do, I'll basically copy that thing and I'll pass the same thing here itself. So once I have done that, so looks like I have successfully deleted the particular student ID. So if I click on hit, so I am not getting any result. So in the last part, we'll be going to discuss about how to delete the particular indices. So for the deleting indices, I think we have discussed these things in my previous tutorial as well. So for deleting the indices, I have to say method of delete and I have to pass the indices name. So again, it's coming from delete API, and which is this one, and delete Elasticsearch indices. I'm calling this function from here itself, and I'm passing the index name here. And if I want to delete the entire index, I can directly pass, instead of index name, I can directly pass underscore all. Okay, so I have the indices of right now student and company. I want to delete the company indices. So what I'm going to do now, I'm basically copy the delete API. I'll say here delete. Delete of company. And again, it's a delete method and I don't have to pass anything. So I'll come here, I'll say it's basically none, and this is a delete API. So before going to hit on send button, let me open the browser and let me refresh it. So you can see that right now I have only company. So I'll open the postman, I hit the API. So you can see the company indices have been successfully deleted, right? Because I'm passing the company here itself. So let me refresh it. So you can see that company indices is gone, right? So this is all about Elasticsearch APIs. I have explained via Node.js. So for your reference, what I'll do, I'll put all my codes into my GitHub repository. And I'll put all the links in my description box below. So if you want, you can basically go ahead from the description box below. You can download the code and you can play with it. In this tutorial, we have learned about Elasticsearch get and post method. Also, we have discussed about how to perform Elasticsearch put and delete method using the Node.js. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed this playlist. I'm going to see you in the next tutorial where we'll discuss about what is Kibana and how to index the data into Kibana. Thank you guys. I got broads in Atlanta. Just to lean the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting the licks in the banner. Legacy.